windy conditions, never the best for a tennis player. How do you think he went?
Yeah, it was, mate. It's tricky conditions. It was a pretty strong wind down the court as well as being gusty, so probably not an ideal day to play your best tennis in terms of timing the ball and striking it, but you know, it's not always ideal conditions, so these young kids have to learn to kind of manage the conditions and find a way to win on days like this, so Daniel did well there.
What has the preparation been like for some of these kids as they get ready for the December showdown?
Mate, most of these kids had the last nationals up in Sydney at the end of September. So they've had, most of these kids are coming into the December showdown with a kind of 5 or 6 week training block. Not just our kids, but most of the boys around the country. So that's what Dan's had, and he's had a good training block. He's been injury free, and you know, he's done all the right things, and hopefully his preparation's been good.
Who are some other players of note that might be really coming into their own for this tournament that we should be aware of?
Mate, I think on the boys' side, New South Wales is probably the favourite, the number one seed, and Jake Delaney, their top player, has had probably the most international experience of all our boys playing this event. He's gone overseas in some of our national teams this year a few times, or the last couple of years, so they've got good number two and three players. They've got good depth as well as a great number one, so they'll be tough to beat. But New Zealand are also pretty good. You know, they've got a very good number one, Kyle Butters, big strong kid. So Ollie Anderson is a year young for this event, but he's the best 98 we've got in the country, and a great player. So, mate, it's a good strong event, and we'll see what happens.
Great. Thank you very much for your time.